It's recording time! Hi, I'm Steven. I am here live at Comics in Pleasanton, California. I got a special treat with you. I am here with a couple of Power Ranger legends. Michael Popod from Power Rangers Triforce and Steve Cardenas, the legendary Mighty Morphin Ranger and Steel Ranger. That's a love, Steve. Anyway, speaking of love, how does it feel that after 25 years, Power Rangers is still going on strong to this very day?
Skinless guy with a brain like Roman's brain, and he had, you know, he was was like so scary that he actually just scared the kids, you know?
So they had to like tone him down a little bit, which is why they had a very beautiful they had their movie little band back and forth, because in the beginning it was like too scary. So I think if they tried to make it edgier at that time, it probably wouldn't work. You know, parents back then were always like already arguing too much that Power Rangers was too violent for the kids at that time. So if it would have made it even darker, that would have been probably not a good idea. Now people's television watching has evolved. So if they want to make something like that's going to be appealing to like Power Rangers fans of all ages, they definitely need to go there right now for sure. Especially if it's going to be in a movie.
Now let's talk about like one of everyone's almost favorite thing about Power Rangers is the amount of diversity. I mean, Steve, you're like actually the first Mexican to be a Red Ranger, and I feel like you don't get that kind of like, you know, acknowledgement, like Silver War being the first African American Red Ranger. How's it going, having that kind of honor?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I think part of that is that, yeah, I was like the first Latino like Power Ranger that was on Power Rangers, but at the same time, like they didn't really touch on it very much either. You know, they didn't really talk much about, you know, Rocky's heritage or anything like that. So I think maybe a lot of people didn't really know. Really acknowledged in the script or anything like that. So I don't know. Because when he used to walk, he just thought I was white, you know? So yeah, I think that, you know, opportunity was missed, you know, in that regard as far as like, you know, kind of being able to kind of like touch on that. So I don't know. I don't know what the process was like that. But I think in general, the different diversity of all Rangers that there was anyway, of course, you know, they had an Asian American, African American, they had, you know, white guy, you know, things like that. So they mixed it up, and that sort of was somehow interesting, kind of sold me anyway, you know.
That makes sense.
And Michael, do you want to talk about being among the first few Filipino Rangers of being here right now for the show?
Yeah, you know, they. Filipino, most of us are nurses or work to the medical field because our parents kind of forced us into that. So me going to Hollywood was like a big no-no to my family. And so for me to get Power Rangers so quickly and not just be one of the first Filipinos to make it on the Power Rangers series, but also got to prove to my family that I could, you know, do what I love to do, which is the art world, and I'd still get paid for it. So that was actually really good for me.
I'm going to open up to audience questions. Does anyone have a question?
If anybody has any questions, shoot it up. You can take the mic and ask your question. If anybody, yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead, Spike.
Louder.
What is, like, an embarrassing, fun moment you had on set? Like, how's it happening? Like, any like, oh man, I can't believe this crazy thing happened. Any kind of those stuff, I've had plenty of those in the actor myself, in the streets, you know, like firsthand. Like, I can't believe this happened. Any of those?
Any embarrassing moments? Where I can see?
Well, me and Jason Vaughn, we would always play jokes in the crew at the castle. Like, one of the scenes in Movie Madness when we were in the back closet of Universal Studios, me and him kind of like, We took our pants off and just had boxer shorts on. So like we came around the corner really serious, but just in our boxer shorts. And like the cast and crew was like, oh my god, guys, can you stop playing around? We're trying to shoot a movie here. We would always do funny stuff like that. Me and Jason would always be in a serious scene. You guys watched the time for us, so you're like, you know, but Jim, we shouldn't do this, but we'd be touching each other's hands. So like Jason and I would always do stuff like that. And then the director and producer was like, guys, you just stop joking around. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I have.
Good question. Anybody else?
Anyone else?
Don't be shy.
Any questions?
We got like five more minutes.
So,
Steve,
like, how do you find Power Rangers? Actually, discover, like, so then you came in, like, season 3 or something like that, you took over Red Ranger Manor. So how did you discover opening a new position there.
I couldn't hear. What was the question?
How did you discover Power Rangers? Like, what made them?
What made you want to audition for the show?
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay.
So, the audition for me was something completely random. I didn't have any aspirations to be an actor or be on TV or anything like that. I was just a martial artist ever since I was a young kid. And one day, I was living in Texas, and one day a commercial came on the radio that said, "If you know how to do martial arts or gymnastics, if you come down to the local TV station this weekend and try out for Power Rangers, you think you could be a Power Ranger, come on down and try out." So I just went to a local casting call that I heard about on the radio, and I just said, "I know how to do martial arts and gymnastics." When I got there, there was like 5,000 people waiting in line. I was like, "Oh, forget it. There's no way I'm going to get the part, you know?" I never dreamed that they would actually call me back. But after I did my audition, they like called me back a couple days later, and they're like, "Hey, you like to audition? The producers want to fly you to California to meet them and talk to them." I'm like, wow. So, yeah, I never expected that. It was something that, you know, like I said, I didn't have any aspirations to do. It was just something that I stumbled into. Really weird. But it was amazing. Awesome,
I'll take it.
Good question. Anyone else got any questions?
As you're over and using your facial likenesses, and they're calling you time for it, like, how does it feel know they're going to do that, and how do you like their new figures?
Oh, right. I'm talking about the new one.
Well, I mean, you know, like, they've had our likeness on the action figures since the very beginning. I remember the first day that I got on set, they had me go to this corner and they took a picture of the front of my face and the side, this side and the back. And I was like, "What's this for?" They go, "Oh, so we can make your action figure with your face on it." I was like, "Wow, this is epic, awesome, you know?" So I was pretty stoked about that. And I've always been proud of that. And I know that now they're coming out with the new action figures for Zio.
I think it was really cool. Just the only thing that bothered me is that our 12-inch dolls, instead of giving us pectoral muscles, they gave us breasts. So you know, like, if you Google our 12-inch doll, and then it doesn't even look like it, but I like their attempt to try to like me.
All right, any more questions?
You too, Spike.
All right, game.
So my question would be, besides your guys' season, what is your actual favorite show to watch?
Your favorite show to watch?
Of the Rangers, which one do you
actually... Oh, Power Rangers! Power Rangers,
which one is your favorite show that you would like to watch? Which one, you know, yeah.
So,
yeah, mine's just easy. Mine's Mighty Go. I watched Mighty Go growing up. I actually went to the movie theater to watch this guy. And then I became a Power Ranger.
Yeah, that's so weird. And honestly, you know, after I left Power Rangers, I didn't watch a lot of the other series. But then once we started traveling around and doing Comic Cons together, which is where I first started meeting the other Rangers in these different shows, I became really good friends with the Time Force. So I'm like, I think it's time to check their series out. And it's actually really cool. I love the concept of the Time Travel right now. So I thought it was pretty cool. So I know it seems so weird because he's sitting right next to me. But it really was Time Force, actually. But that's a tribute to me meeting these guys outside of that, you know, what made me want to watch that.
Yeah.
So that's kind of where that's
at. Yeah, we all, like, it's kind of surreal for me because, like, I actually legit paid for a ticket with my family, went to the movies, watched them, didn't know, you know, 7 years later I'd be a Power Ranger, and then, you know, almost 20 years later I would be. We've been to Bolivia together, numerous states, countries, London.
All over the world.
Yeah, you know. So like our season, Time Force is really close to season. So yeah, two top seasons. And I hear a lot about STD as well.
Yeah.
make this the last one.
Last one, guys.
There you go.
Really blue, but then had holes in it. Have you ever wear those sunglasses with holes? Kind of like the Randy Savage glasses or whatever, and you can see through them. It's kind of like, that's kind of how it was so that way you give off the blue effect, but you can still see through it. But it was still almost really hard to see through. So the stunt guys, I was still amazed how much stunts they did with being able to bear
that limited visibility.
Yeah, they would flip and do all this stuff and land perfectly. I mean, they were amazing. I mean, really, they made this.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
We'll be at our table.